Hello everyone. Today we are going to study windmills under the topic wind and bioenergy, which is the fourth module of our syllabus. In last lecture, we studied the wind energy, the power from the wind, etc. So there are various ways the data on wind is collected depending on the use. The hourly mean wind velocity as collected by the meteorological observations is the basic data which is used in windmill designs. The hourly mean is the average over a particular hour of the day, over the day, month, year and years. There are some factors which affect the nature of the wind. Close to the surface of the earth, and they are latitude of the place, altitude of the place, topography, scale of the hours, spells of low wind speeds and gust, and height and location. So we know that winds being an unsteady phenomenon, the scale of periods considered is an important data which is required in the design. The hourly mean velocity provides the data for establishing the potential of the place for tapping the wind energy. Then the scale of the month is useful to indicate whether it is going to be useful during a particular period of the year. The data based on scale of the hour is useful for mechanical aspects of design. And in addition to the data on the hourly mean velocity, two other informations are required, are spells of low wind speeds and gust. A number of criteria can be applied in estimating the importance of wind potential as a function of height and location. Careful sighting is important because wind speed near the ground is greatly affected by houses, trees and similar features. Wind speed increases with height above the ground. The rate of increase being about the same at all locations. Therefore, if wind speed at a given height is known, then speed at any height may be calculated. The best sites for wind energy are found offshore and on the sea coast. Then best sites are in mountains, etc. Then we also know the advantages and disadvantages of wind energy, which are it is a renewable source of energy. Like solar energy, wind power system are non-polluting. So it has no adverse influence on the environment. Wind energy systems avoid fuel provision and transport. There are some disadvantages also, such as wind energy available is dilute and fluctuating in nature. Then wind energy needs storage capacity because of its irregularity. Then the wind energy systems are noisy in operation. Then its overall weight is very high. Then it requires large area, etc. These are the disadvantages of wind energy. Then windmills types and performance. So, windmill is a device or a machine that converts the kinetic energy of the wind into mechanical energy. Then, how do windmills work? So, it was found that mostly three blades worked, the best, and that's how every windmill has a three blades because its performance is better. The energy source for windmill is wind. Of course, when the blades come in contact with the wind, the blades move such that the shaft starts to spin, resulting in the production of electricity. The generator converts the mechanical energy into electrical energy. A wind turbine converts the kinetic energy of the wind motion to mechanical energy, which is transmitted by the shaft. A generator further converts each into electrical energy. Then use of windmill. The main purpose of windmill is to convert wind energy into electrical energy. And when electrical energy is obtained, the following are the ways it is used. First, windmill is used for pumping of groundwater, then extraction of oil from seeds, milling of the grains, etc. The main system used to extract the energy from these fluids is a turbine, which is a rotating mechanical device that has the capacity to extract energy from fluid flow and transmit it into usable work. Windmills are generally classified as horizontal axis windmill or wind turbine and vertical axis wind turbine. Depending on their axis of rotation. Then working of horizontal axis wind turbine, as wind blows, a wind turbine converts kinetic energy of the wind motion into mechanical energy by the rotation of the rotor, and this mechanical energy is transmitted by the shaft to the generator through the gear box. This gear, the generator further converts this mechanical energy into electrical energy, means generating electricity. Horizontal axis windmills have their axis of rotation horizontal to the ground, so called horizontal axis, and almost parallel to the wind stream. As wind stream interacts with the rotor blades, lift force is generated and motor rotates. The rotational speed varies with design features and the size of motor. For a typical megawatt size turbine, this could be as low as 16 rpm, that is revolution per minute. The low speed main shaft transmits this rotation to the high speed shaft through the gearbox. The speed is enhanced by the gear trains to match with higher speed requirement of the generator. Generator converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. The number of rotor blades in a horizontal axis wind turbine varies depending on the applications for which they are used. So, based on number of blades, these rotors can be classified as a single bladed, two bladed, three bladed, and multi bladed. An upwind turbine has its rotor fixed in front of the wind, directly facing the incoming wind stream, and in opposite, the downwind turbines have their rotors positioned at the backside, leaving the nacelle to face the wind first, as shown in the figure. This figure shows upwind and downwind. Then this figure shows constructional features of a typical horizontal axis wind turbine. And this is a actual figure. So this horizontal axis wind turbine consists of hub, then blades, main shaft, then gearbox, generator. This is high speed shaft and tower, and all these components are enclosed, that is called as a housing. So first component is a blade, which harvests the wind energy. Wind exert a force on the blades, causing the rotor to spin. These are designed most effectively to capture the energy of strong and fast winds. Some European companies manufacture single blade turbines. Then rotor. Rotor consists of blades and the hub. The rotor is aerodynamically designed to occupy the maximum surface area of the wind, to spin the most mostly. The blades are lightweight, durable and corrosion resistant material. The base material are composites of fiberglass and reinforced plastic. The nacelle, a housing which contain all the components which are essential to operate the turbine efficiently, is called nacelle. It is mounted on the top of a tower and include gearbox, generator, controller and brake. The next component is gearbox. A gearbox magnifies or amplifies the energy output of the rotor. The gearbox is located between the rotor and generator. It rotates the generator guided by the tail. A rotor vane. This converts wind energy into rotary mechanical energy. Then controller. Controller senses wind direction, wind speed, power output of the generator, rotor and other performance quantities of the system, and initiates proper control signals to take suitable corrective action. Generator. This unit produces electricity from the rotation of the rotor. The generator comes in various sizes with respect to the output. Generator converts mechanical energy into electrical power. The output power of the generator coupled to the load or system grid. And last component is supporting structure. This is the heavy structure set up with a proper foundation and carries all the components of the windmill. It should be properly designed with a proper factor of safety to withstand a dead load of all components and wind force. And we know that anemometer, what is about when anemometer? It is used to measure the wind speed. The collected data are transmitted to the controller unit, for instance, to stop the wind turbine at very high speeds. Then brake. This brake stops the rotor in case of emergency. Horizontal axis wind turbines utilize aerodynamic blades fitted to a rotor, which can be positioned either upwind or downwind. And we already know about upwind and downwind. Typically, these type of wind turbines are two or three bladed and operate at high blade tip speeds. Machines with upwind rotors require a tail vane to help them orient into the wind, while downwind rotors have blades that are cone shaped, allowing the turbine to orient on its own. These turbines have the main rotor shaft electrical generator at the top of tower, and rotor is oriented perpendicular to the wind. So most of them are equipped with a gearbox which transforms the slow rotation of the rotor into a faster rotation suitable to drive the electrical generator. These turbines are generally used, mostly these type of turbines are used. Horizontal axis wind turbines are the most common design, and they are available ranging from 50 watt to 4.5 megawatt. The number of blades ranges from one to many in the familiar agriculture windmills. The best use of these windmills is for the electricity generation, where high rotational speed allows us of a smaller and cheaper electric generator is two or three blades. The mechanical and aerodynamic balance is better for three bladed rotor. In a small wind turbines, three blades are common. Multi-blade wind turbines are used for water pumping on farms. Then the types of rotors or horizontal axis wind turbine. There are four types of rotors. First one is a multi-bladed, which is shown in figure. Number of blades are used here. Then a cell type rotor, then a propeller type, and fourth one is four bladed type rotor, or it is also called as a Dutch type. Both multi-blade and cell type mills run at a speed of 60 to 80 rpm. The propeller type has a 2 or 3 aerofoil blades and runs at a speed of 300 to 400 rpm. These rotors have to face the direction of the wind in order to generate wind power. 4 blade type rotor is shown in figure. This motor runs at a low speed in the range of 100 to 150 rpm. Which is the rotors are made up of wooden or a special type of cloth. Then a vertical axis wind turbine generator. These types of wind turbines, the axis of rotation is vertical, so the name is given vertical axis. The sails or blades may also be vertical. Vertical axis wind turbines are a type of wind turbine where the main rotor shaft is set transferred to the wind, but not necessarily vertically, while the main components are located at the base of the turbine. This arrangement allows the generator and gearbox to be located close to the ground. Its components are rotor, braking system, generator, control system, and tower. The function of rotor is to produce aerodynamic efficiency. It is constituted of light but resistant material and provided with a protective layer. The function of braking system is to stop the rotor motion in adverse weather conditions. It is constituted of disc brakes similar to those of cars and of friction brakes, which function in case of failure of the electrical grid. Then the control system regulates the function of the aerogenerator according to the different working conditions. It optimizes the function of the aerogenerator and it ensures safety and controls any further devices, means for any momentum. And last one is the tower. It has to withstand the action of wind and the weight of the blades. It is generally tabular or tabular, and the base can be either superfilled or deep. Then the working of vertical axis wind turbine. Figure shows vertical axis wind turbine generator. The blades are aerofoil shape and it can take the wind from any direction. The rotor is not self-starting. The base of wind turbine rotor is coupled to a generator by a drive flexible coupling. Here the blades rotate around a vertical axis. So this figure shows gearbox, then a generator. This is lower hub, rotor blades, guy wire. The wire whose strength is very high, and upper hub. Wind turbine captures the high pressure wind and it causes the kinetic energy. This kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy and then into electric power. The generated electric power is taken by the static frequency converter from the generator at a variable frequency, that is from 0 to 20 hertz, and supplies a constant frequency output, that is 60 hertz, and feeds to the grid. This static frequency converter also controlled by a microprocessor based control system. There are different types of rotors for vertical axis wind turbine, like a Savonius type rotor and Darius type rotor. Figure shows Savonius type rotor. This consists of a hollow circular cylinder sliced in half. Two holes being fixed to a vertical axis with a gap in between. Torque is produced by the pressure difference between two sides of the half facing the wind. The design is efficient but requires a large surface area. Second one is a Darius type, requires much less surface area. It is shaped like an egg beater and has three blades shaped like aerofoils. Both the 7S and Darius type rotor run independently of the direction of the wind because they rotate about the vertical axis. On the other hand, the horizontal axis machines have to face the direction of the wind in order to generate power.